Hey guys, Rick Hogg with War HOGG Tactical. Just want to go over my War HOGG V Drill, which is a modified of the War HOGG W. As you can see, it's out here raining. That's all right. You guys got to get out. You've got to get out and train. Again, if you guys don't have these orange cones, I highly recommend you do, because they're invaluable to just setting up kind of some different movement exercise drills. So let me talk about the weather here for a little bit. Yep, it's raining. That's okay, because I've got my Walther pistol here. If you notice, I'm running the Aimpoint Acro. The thing I like with this Acro, where it's an enclosed red dot sight, I'm not worried about water or anything else getting on there, and a piece of water getting on the emitter and then me losing my dot. So just something to think about with your equipment. The other thing is, you've got to get out and try your equipment out in the rain. You know what? I know it's not the funnest thing to do, but this is what will validate, hey, whether this equipment works or not. So kind of enough of that. Let's go over kind of how this drill and what we're looking to do. So really what I'm looking to do is start up here at the top of my orange cone. I can change the variable how I want. I can draw from the holster, I can start from the ready. However you want to do it, it doesn't matter. But the point being is, I'm going to sit there, I'm going to fire a shot here. The key thing is, I need to get a hit. Boom. Once I get my hit, then I'm clear to go. I'm going to move up here to the second cone. As soon as this plant foot steps, boom, I can fire the next shot, get that good hit. Now the key is, when I'm moving backwards, you're going to see the pistol will come back. I'm actually physically looking where I'm going. I'm stepping up here, conducting my pivot. I'm going to fire and get two hits here. Once I'm done, bring the pistol back, identify the next point, step, drive, get my good hit on target, and then I'm coming back here and get my final shot to kind of finish this drill off. So go ahead, get your eyes and ears on. Let me run this thing live for you. So again, we'll go through our War HOGG administrative load. Draw my pistol out. Gives me a chance to make sure my red dot's good, which it is. I lock my slide to the rear, get my mag out, drive it forward, do my War HOGG check, and I'm good to go. And again, where I've cleared a mag out of position number one, I want to make sure to get it set back up in there. So again, I'm just going to start this thing from draw from the holster. And then again, ideally, once I've run that, if I can get a pro timer, and again, you gotta look at the pro timer, I have to have it in a plastic bag and stuff like that. But now I'm getting a tangible on my time, and that's what you wanna do. So now when I come back and run this drill again, I know what my tangible time is. I kinda know where my goals are. I can see where my shortcomings are. Ideally, if I can record this thing and see my movement to make sure my foot movement is working as well, that would be ideal. But make sure you guys are out there training, get out in the weather, test your equipment, and be ready that, God forbid, you're ever in a deadly force encounter, you're ready to deal with it.